buggy whip drivers that don't exist in our economy anymore. Tell us five occupations that exist now that aren't going to exist in 20 years, and five occupations that we haven't heard of that will exist.
Well, you know, it's interesting. A lot of the companies that are being successful with digital transformation are taking their emerging leaders, their digital natives, if you will, and they're putting them in charge of these transformation efforts. So I think in the future there's going to be a chief work officer. Right? And let me tell you why. The average knowledge worker only spends 39% of their time doing the job they were hired to do. This is a real digital work crisis. And so companies are starting to focus on people that have the skills to figure out how can they do their work in a new way.
So, how about occupations that won't exist?
Yeah. What?
I don't have a great perspective on it will or won't.
Don't say print journalist.
We've heard that one before.
No, that will always exist. And the reason why is because humans are feeling beings that think. And so no matter what automation ever happens, there is still going to need to be a human touch in a corporation.
Facial recognition, is that going to be a big deal going forward?
I believe it is. If I can unlock my iPhone with my face, I think that we'll find lots of uses for that.
Yeah, well, yeah, camera's always on. Alex, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Alex Shootman joining us there. Thanks, Matt, to talk more about that.
This is disappointing, Fox News. So I was able to go to CES, which is the technology trade show in Vegas, to display all the new technology, and I spent a lot of time in artificial intelligence. And so, once again, he dodged the bullet. So jobs that are going to get outsourced, I'm sure there's plenty of videos, but obviously, you know, Uber drivers, anything that's just a basic brainless work will be done. And what he did bring up is creativity, you know, content creation, YouTube creators. You're not going to get outsourced by robots. And what I would also recommend, or what I'm seeing change, is obviously software. Because remember, as artificial intelligence replaces these boring jobs, there's going to be people that need to write code, to update the code, and to be able to make sure that, you know, to continue to innovate and to continue to take the data that the AI collects that's making it smarter to become smart. So if you are a person trying to prepare for the future of artificial intelligence, what I would recommend is become tech savvy. And people that don't have any interest in technology and spend most of their time doing other things, I think you're going to be left behind. So the more, and like I said, if you're a cryptocurrency enthusiast, you're already kind of technologically savvy, and maybe you haven't gone the whole way, maybe you haven't opened up a wallet, and maybe you haven't sent digital assets around yet, or opened up the coding aspect of cryptocurrencies. But this is all skills that I would highly recommend for someone who's trying to take advantage of this revolution. And like I said, in our lifetime, and when I'm saying our lifetime, millennials, people that are under the age of 30, we're going to see a lot of evolution. And the people that are nimble and the people that know where the opportunities are going to profit. And if you have any kind of experience, you can see this in the internet, right? The people born in the 70s and 80s were able to kind of take advantage of this dot-com boom. As you can tell, some of the new billionaires, you know, Mark Zuckerberg and I guess Bezos and people like that are going to be able to utilize the new technology. And that's why I do feel like artificial intelligence will create a lot of opportunity for the people that are able to adjust. And the best thing you could do is educate yourself. And what's great about YouTube, there's so much free content to continue to better yourself. So less Kardashian watching and more technology and investment education would probably be good for the future. But let me know your thoughts on this, and I will talk to you soon.